Live and on demand from the WNY News Now studios in downtown Jamestown. This is WNY News Now.
And thanks for joining us for WNY News Now on this Thursday. I'm Justin Gould. Our Matt Hummel is on assignment. Happening now, big breaking news, a City of Jamestown man is convicted of second-degree murder today in Chautauqua County Court. Hummel is standing by live. Plus, two people are facing charges following a stabbing this week. But first, let's get a check of our forecast. Chief Forecaster Dakota Hunter standing by for us live. Hey, Dakota.
Hey, Jay, and happy Thursday to all of you. And as we take a live look at the Mill Creek Mall Sky Vision camera, we've seen a few raindrops popping on the camera lens. The rain is approaching, and the temperatures are already are in the 50s in some spots because of the partial sunshine that we had already this morning. You can see this batch of rain that is coming in, our way out of the west. It will be overspreading the region throughout the day today. It's going to be on again, off again, rain showers. It's not going to be anything widespread or anything heavy, but you will be dodging a few raindrops. Again, the good news is the rain's going to help knock down some of this tree pollen because that's what we're dealing with right now. But we all know as we go throughout the spring and the summer, this is just going to get worse for all of us who have terrible allergies. Temperatures today should at least hover around 50 before the rain comes in. That'll knock us back down into the 40s. But rain is the story through the day, also through tomorrow. But we're keeping our eyes on another storm system over the weekend. We'll talk about it with that Weatherhood Property Maintenance 7-Day later on in the show.
All right, Dakota, thank you. Our top story is Chautauqua County jury found David Wagner guilty of second-degree murder Thursday morning in Mayville. Wagner is convicted in the shooting death of William Mishishima, who was shot and killed last summer on Livingston Avenue in Jamestown. The jury had the option of finding Wagner not guilty or guilty of second-degree manslaughter. The defense claimed that Mishishima was the initial aggressor, while the prosecution noted Wagner had his companion hide two firearms, including the .22 caliber handgun believed to be the murder weapon. Our Matt Hummel is standing by live outside of Chautauqua County Court with more on this case. Matt, good afternoon to you.
Hey, good afternoon, Justin. And just to clarify real quick, because I know we had a couple questions both on the website and on our Facebook page, here were the options that the jury was able to hear. They were able to convict on either second-degree murder or a lesser-included offense of second-degree manslaughter. They could convict on one or the other or not both. Now, if the jury would have hypothetically found Wagner not guilty on second-degree murder for justification, it would have been over right away. If he was found not guilty for second-degree murder for any other reason, they would have been able to consider second-degree manslaughter. But nonetheless, again, we had a conviction for second-degree murder for David Wagner. Now, following the announcement this morning in court, we spoke with Chautauqua County District Attorney Patrick Swanson. He says that each individual case is up to the jury.
You know, we put the case in front of the jury that we have, and we hope they do the right thing. But ultimately, our jury process is based on those people from our community that give up part of their lives to come in here and hear proof. And the verdict they render is based on what they believe. So previous verdicts we've had and this one, they're all handed down by the same group of people. We feel that in this case, they saw the evidence, they heard our case, and they convict this man justly.
Now, Swanson also did credit the Jamestown Police Department for their work in this investigation. Following the interview with Patrick Swanson, WNY News Now was also able to receive comment from Chautauqua County Public Defender Ned Barone, who is the chief representative for Mr. Wagner in the trial. Barone says that at this point he will, if it becomes necessary, file an appeal, and he is currently preparing to file post-trial motions.
Of course, you know, he's upset, and he's disappointed as well. And you know, it's a very difficult, you know, difficult time right now. So, but you know, like I said, we'll look forward to working on any post-verdict motions, and we'll look forward to working on the sentence and any appeal that may be necessary.
Now, speaking to both men after, District Attorney Patrick Swanson was noncommittal about what kind of sentence he will push for when sentencing occurs on June 10th of this year. Ned Barone, meanwhile, tells us that he, of course, will push for the lighter sentence, and we will provide coverage June 10th when Mr. Wagoner is sentenced in front of Judge David Foley here in Chautauqua County Court.
All right. Matt Hummel reporting live for us there in Mayville. Great reporting, Matt. Thank you. Other news we're following, two Jamestown residents are facing multiple charges after they allegedly stabbed a woman in the face during a burglary Wednesday afternoon. Chautauqua County Sheriff's deputies responded to a report of a stabbing on Kent Street in the village of St. Clairville. The victim told deputies that two people broke into her home and stabbed her. The two then fled in a vehicle, that according to the victim. Deputies found the vehicle and arrested the duo, 23-year-old Kayla Seberg and 18-year-old Jacob Graham. They were taken to the Chautauqua County Jail for arraignment on a number of charges. The victim's condition was not released to the media. And there are sure signs of spring out there. Robins, geese flying north, and potholes big enough to swallow your car. YourMechanic.com reports that most drivers who hit the road hazards experience five main issues with their cars, starting with the tires. Tires are meant to be the only part of your car that touches the roadway, so it isn't a surprise that they're susceptible to pothole damage like sidewalk bulges, tread separation, or flats. Now, since exhaust pipes run along the undercarriage of a car, they're a perfect target for potholes as well. Those who face costly repairs might want to file a claim against the New York State Department of Transportation. Just know, though, it could take several weeks to hear back from them. DOT officials say drivers who want to be reimbursed for repairs made after an encounter with a pothole should do it sooner than later. If the damage happens to your car more than 3 months ago, you're out of luck. Officials say once filed, a claim could take up to 8 weeks to process. If the state believes that they're not in the wrong, you won't receive payment, but you will receive a letter explaining why they didn't find in your favor. So how do you file a claim? Well, we have a web story on our website, WNYNewsNow.com, that explains it all. The recently released Chautauqua Lake Plan from County Executive George Borrello has friends in high places. Congressman Tom Reed told WNY News Now yesterday that he supports the lake plan, but that the next key step is finding funding for water treatment facilities along the lake.
We are partnering with him on not only those initial steps that have occurred and investments from the federal level that have been made in order to allow for that planning to occur, but now we have to find money for things like the wastewater treatment facilities around the lake. We need to find ways to fund those sewer systems that are going to go a long way to helping eliminate nutrient load there that is causing, in my opinion, the root cause of the weed problem of the lake.
Now, Reed said the partnership among federal, state, county, and local lawmakers best serves the need of the people here. The county legislature approved the agreement last night at their regular meeting. Well, good Thursday to all of you. Thanks so much for joining us here on WNY News Now. Want to say hello to Lori. Hopefully you are doing well. Gary, hello to you as well. Mike is joining us. Good afternoon to you, sir. Looks like Nathan is here. Thanks so much for tuning in to WNY News Now here at noon. We're live every day with local news you need to know, and download our app, WNY News Now, for the Apple App Store and the Google Play Store. Good afternoon to you, David. I totally agree. Our Matt Hummel has done an excellent job. We were just talking about that this morning when we broke the news of the verdict. He's quite the court reporter, so he does an excellent job. Miss having him in studio, but love seeing the success nonetheless. Hello to Cindy and hello to Mark. Good afternoon. Hopefully you are well, sir. Hello to Joe. Great to see you, sir. And Wendy as well. Good afternoon to you. Connie is joining us. Beth is here. And it looks like Chrissy is here as well. Good afternoon to all of you. Coming up, so much more to tell you about why a local candidate running for New York State Senate sent a message to lawmakers, what he has to say. But first, why fire officials are warning residents to obey the burn ban, Dakota.
And that burn ban definitely is serious. I'll be interested. Well, I know the reason why. The high yesterday was 51 degrees, and that felt good. And yeah, temperatures will go down for the weekend. We'll talk about it coming up. News Now at Noon continues in just a couple minutes.
Live and on demand, you're watching WNY News Now.
Now open in downtown Jamestown, Pearl City Hops Restaurant and Tavern.
I have some real old-timey dishes on there that I'm just giving new life to. Like there's a shepherd's pie on there that's gonna have some bison in it, you know, real thick hearty gravy. Then I'm also doing beer flights. We're pairing it with a set of sliders, a set of tacos, and a set of mini rolls. So everything's gonna have its own pair, so you can get a taste of a little bit of everything and all the beers. We don't wanna be known as the restaurant in the hotel. We want to be known as Pearl City Hops.
You're watching WNY News Now, your source for breaking news.
EagleZip.com is your local one-stop shop for all of your home and business computer needs. Located on Fluvanna Avenue Extension, just outside of Jamestown, EagleZip.com sells and services all brands of desktops and laptops, as well as servers and network equipment for your business. All new computer sales include transferring your data from your old computer plus a two-year warranty. Call EagleZip.com today.
Stop by EagleZip.com today and let us make computers easy for you.
The Falconer Volunteer Fire Department battled a 7-acre grass fire Wednesday afternoon in the Kennedy Fire District. Now, Falconer Fire was dispatched to a large field fire. Engine 402 went en route with a full crew of interior firefighters. 500 feet of cross lays were deployed to fight that blaze, which was roughly 7 acres, was burned there. Frewsburg Equipment and Chautauqua County EMS Medic 74 also assisted on the scene. Now, the cause of that fire was not released. The fire is a reminder, though, that the burn ban is still in effect through May 14th. Warming temperatures can quickly cause wildfire conditions to arise. DEC posts a daily fire danger rating map and forecasts during the fire season. For more, visit our website, WNYNewsNow.com. Well, Austin Morgan, the Democratic candidate for the 57th state Senate seat, called on state lawmakers to not forget the district during budget negotiations just because the local state Senate seat is vacant. Morgan sent a letter to legislative leaders and New York State Governor Andrew Cuomo, urging them to pass a budget beneficial to all areas of the state. Morgan also listed several funding priorities for the district. In his letter, Morgan listed among those priorities are school aid, decreasing taxes, increased CHIP funding to repair failing infrastructure, health funding to assure hospital staffing levels, and protection from unfunded mandates, investments in green energy transition, grants for local libraries, fire departments, and natural resource preservation for Allegheny, Letchworth, state parks, and Chautauqua and Lake Erie as well. Congressman Tom Reed called for Democrats to accept the findings by Robert Mueller that President Donald Trump did not collude with Russians to win the 2016 presidential election. The congressman also said someone needs to investigate the FBI agents who were at the helm of the collusion charge. Since 2017, Mueller has been special counsel of the Russian collusion investigation, which found no evidence that Trump colluded with the Russians in the 2016 national election. Now, in response to a WNY News Now question, Reed said it is important to investigate the pair of FBI special agents who seem to push the collusion story. And do you have a credit? Did you have a credit card when you were a kid? Chances are probably not. I sure didn't. But that's not the case with a lot of kids today. A new report finds more and more parents are trusting their children with plastic. Mary Maloney explains this growing money move.
How much credit do you give your child? For some, it's apparently a lot. 8% of parents with kids under 18 say that at least one child has a credit card. That's according to a new report released by creditcards.com. 21% of parents said their children used their credit cards without their permission at least once. The report also found the more a parent makes, the more likely a child is to have plastic. 13% of parents who make more than $80,000 a year have a credit card carrying child. That's compared with 5% of parents in the under $40,000 a year category. The survey found location may also play a role. 13% of children with credit cards live in the Northeast, 8% live in the South, and 5% in the Midwest. Underage children can apply for their own credit cards, but they can be added to their parents' card accounts as authorized users. The downside? Experts say that kids can make unauthorized purchases and ruin their parents' credit. However, there are benefits to giving your child a credit card. Experts say it gives children a head start building their credit and learning how to manage their finances. For Consumer Watch, I'm Mary Maloney.
All right, Mary, thank you. I always figured it was those Beverly Hills babes who had all of the credit cards as children. But it does, I suppose, make sense in a way. Higher income, you give it to your kid, you pay it off, but every time that new Fortnite update comes out, they probably charge that sucker up through the roof, so I don't know about you. Hopefully everybody's having a great Thursday. Yesterday, I messed up and I got called out for it. For some reason, right in this very moment of the broadcast, I said Happy Monday, even though I got the rest of the day as Wednesday, so I'm sorry for that if I gave anyone PTSD or something, because it's not Monday, the weekend is almost here, and the weekend's not looking too bad temp-wise, but it's certainly not looking that great weather-wise, so we'll get to that in a minute. Hello to Mark has joined us as well. Joe is chiming in about the credit card. Joe said, had a card 34 years, and daughter used my card once. And yeah, I suppose, you know, in a way, like, when I was a kid, I would buy, like, you know, they were out traveling or something, and we're, you know, I'm hungry and I want to get something from a McDonald's in an airport or something like that. You know, my mom has given me her card and said, go get whatever you want, come back, don't buy everything. So certainly, you know, that's always an option. Happy Sunday to you too, Gary. You know, Sunday is actually my least favorite day, Gary, because the work week starts up again. I feel like we should have Mondays off and Friday's off, but then nothing would get done. So, hello to Josh. Hopefully you are doing well and enjoying some of this warm weather, because coming up next, Chief Forecaster Dakota Hunter tells us what's to come in the Brotherhood Property Maintenance Forecast. And a little bit later on, art is on display at St. Bonaventure University. Where is it coming from? Somewhere local, we'll tell you in just a bit.
When I'm streaming and I'm talking to my community, we have that literally split second interaction. If somebody says hello, I say hello right back immediately, and it kind of creates that connection. Because like my subscribers and my followers, we pretty much go by Reups Army. All the hate and everything that goes around, that's kind of like our mission statement. It's just like, just be positive and enjoy each other's time. It's more or less just trying to use the internet in a positive way. Like, we all from around the world get to connect on the same level, which is, you know, we all love video games. Mixer.com/Reup. I'm live every single day, 8 p.m.
With coverage that matters, this is WNY News Now.
Turn to Brotherhood Property Maintenance for all your lawn care and landscaping needs, no matter the season. Brotherhood Property Maintenance does it all, from professional plowing during the winter months to expert landscaping all summer long. Count on Brotherhood Property Maintenance for mowing, landscaping, tree work, spring and fall cleanup, plus snow removal. Serving both commercial and residential lots, check out Jamestown's fastest growing landscaping crew on Facebook or call us right now to book an appointment.
First Defense Weather, the Southern Tier's only live and local weather source. Now, here's Chief Forecaster Dakota Hunter.
Parents giving their kids credit cards? I didn't even have a credit card as a kid. I had a, I didn't even have a cable box in my room as a kid. I had something called an imagination. Anyway, how the times have changed. Yesterday, we made it to 52 degrees officially at the airport, but on this hour-by-hour temperature graphic, it's actually up to 51. Some of the local observation sites, we can't vouch for their accuracy, showed about 55 in the afternoon. They're not going to go down as the official high, but who cares when it was in the 50s? It was nice yesterday. School bus stop forecast for the kids coming home from school, speaking of which. 46 to 50 this afternoon. You'll be dodging a few raindrops as they head off the bus, but that's around seasonal. Tomorrow morning we start around 36 to 40. Have that umbrella handy, in the words of Sheriff Buford T. Justice. Have that handy, but it won't be quite as chilly, so that's the good news relating to that. In terms of rainfall, we've had nothing pretty much over the past 7 days, which is good, because here's the thing here. With all the ice starting to break up and melt across the area with area streams and creeks and rivers, we don't need heavy rainfall at the end of March. Here's what's going on with the setup here. A cold front lurking back to our west. This is going to be moving our way today and then tomorrow. You can see the rain shower sparking out ahead of that front, and there's some severe weather occurring behind it, but the good news is that's going to stay away from us. As we zoom right into western New York here, you can see here that the rain is approaching. It is coming our way out of the west, so the rain will be filling in throughout the afternoon today. But again, it's not going to be widespread rain. It's going to be on again, off again type of rain. We'll show that to you here. Well, first of all, here is the HD News Now cam. Clouds downtown. Right now it's 51 degrees. This likely will be our high for today. We'll see if that the rain will knock us down, but I think this might be our high for today. Southwest wind to 14. Next, the wind chill down to 46. But all in all, that's seasonal. Now let's show you a future scan here. We're showing you the future. And you can see here the rain will start to come our way again. It's not anything widespread. It's on again, off again type of rain. It's scattered activity. And then tomorrow morning's same thing here. But as we go into tomorrow afternoon, this is where we're going to get the more widespread rain. But it doesn't look like anything too heavy right now. Looks like we'll have a break Friday night before more rain starts to come our way Saturday associated with another storm system. So again, in terms of the rainfall amounts, I mean, you know, this is running, but it's taking a while for the rain to actually start to come up here. And you can see here that it will take a little bit longer through the afternoon for some real rain to start to register. That's a mouthful. Let's show you zone by zone here, town by town for today. We'll start in the eastern counties first. This is where we're likely going to be for the early afternoon when the rain starts to come in. That'll knock our temperatures down through the 40s. Eastward we go here to the Lake Erie shoreline, lower 50s here. But again, a few rain showers, and it will be a little bit breezy as well. Next 7 days of your life, there they are. 49 tomorrow, 57 Saturday. And again, we're kind of dazed and confused over the weekend. Rain showers on Saturday, but snow showers Saturday night, Sunday. A couple inches of slushy accumulation, likely all elevation based. April Fools, no fooling there. Sunshine and temperatures return to the 50s for next week. Sports is next, don't go away.
Invest in your business or cause by letting the marketing gurus at WNY News Now and WNY Media Company grow your business.
Purchase an ad much like the one you are watching now on WNY News Now's daily show, News Now at Noon, WNYNewsNow.com, or our brand new mobile app.
And then get feedback from our marketing experts and fans alike.
And finally, watch your business grow.
As an added bonus, community partners' messages will run not only on our scheduled programming, but on weather alerts and breaking news as well.
Plus, messages are shared on WNY Sports Now programming. Anything from a live local basketball game to the Phone Zone Sports Desk.
Become part of our family today.
And contact us right now.
You're watching WNY News Now, where coverage comes first. WNY Sports Now is powered by Phone Zone of Jamestown. With the largest inventory around, we buy and sell our own merchandise at a price that can't be beat. Have a broken screen? We'll fix it. Learn more at PhoneZoneShop.com.
Happy Thursday, sports fans. We are nearing the end of the work week. Welcome back to WNY News Now. I'm Norm Rodriguez with a look at sports. On Wednesday, Xavier Chernak, who has been the interim head coach for the JCC Jayhawks basketball team since November, was officially named the full-time head coach for the men's team on Wednesday. Under Chernak's leadership, the Jayhawks men's basketball team made it to the Region 3 Division 2 semifinals during this past season. Chernak is also a former JCC basketball player as well as for Edinburgh University. Just 2 weeks after signing a contract extension, Nate Oates, the coach of the UB Bulls men's basketball team for the last 5 years, became the head coach of the University of Alabama on Wednesday. Oates resigned despite signing an extension to remain the Bulls head coach through 2024. The Buffalo Bulls were eliminated in the second round of March Madness on Saturday, losing 78-58 to Texas Tech. During the season under Oates' tutelage in 2018, the Bulls became nationally ranked for the first time in the program's history. Oates also led UB to a single-season record 32 wins this past season. Sticking with college basketball, hopefully all of your brackets have not been busted already. Starting tonight will be the NCAA March Madness Sweet 16 for men's basketball. 4 games will be played tonight with tip-offs ranging from 7:09 p.m. to 9:57 p.m. The other 4 games will be played on Friday with tip-offs ranging from 7:09 p.m. to 9:59 p.m. The winners will advance to the NCAA Elite 8, which will begin on Saturday. All of these games can be streamed on both NCAA.com and on the March Madness app. That's it for sports today. Justin, back to you.
All right, Norm, thank you very much. Well, artwork from 8 Jamestown High School students was recently selected from more than 300 entries to be part of the Regina A. Quick Center for the Arts Jurd High School Art Show at St. Bonaventure University. Jamestown High School students selected for the show were from 12th, 11th, and 10th grades. Work was chosen for admittance by 4 judges who are working professionals in the arts and higher education field. Now, entry was determined using a number of criteria drawn from college-level rubrics in the visual arts, as well as other Jurd art exhibition guidelines and requirements from the surrounding area. Now, we see some of this work here on the screen. Jamestown High School artwork selected was created throughout the year during the advanced studio art classes. And let me tell you, Dakota, It looks pretty good, doesn't it?
Yeah, it does. Now, I think studio art is actually sort of like a required class for all high school students because I know I took it. And, You know, I'm not very good at art, but I did take cartooning, and that was pretty fun.
Yeah, absolutely. So great job, but certainly more art than I could create. You do a pretty good job. I know our graphics producer does a lot of work for weather, but you do a pretty good job with the weather graphics.
If we didn't have the template, it would be a disaster.
Yeah, that's true. Hey, so want to bring on a Rory Pelero, who didn't surprise any of us this morning with that outfit that you're wearing. Why are you? Whoa! I thought it was gonna. Gonna flash.
He wants his Jerry beads.
So why are you so decked out in the orange and blue?
Because today is opening day of baseball, and I'm a Cubs fan.
Yeah. So
this should be a national holiday, in my opinion.
Yeah. I mean, I mean, really, baseball, so it's going to be going on pretty much all day long today?
All day until the end of the year, yes.
Wow, yeah. So, and the thing with Rory's Cubbies is you refer to their stadium and pretty much any baseball stadium as church.
Yes.
Right?
Chris Norberg and I do.
Yeah.
When we go in there, I genuflect in the name of Ruth, DiMaggio, and Gehrig, but that's blasphemous if you're not a baseball fan.
Awesome. Well, cool. Well, good luck to your Cubs. They play today?
They play today against the Texas Rangers in an inter-squad opener at 4:05.
Awesome.
Our time.
We'll be cheering in Milan. So, cool.
I hope whoever your favorite team is, they do well, but come in second to my Cubs.
Oh, thanks, boy. Ray. Here's a look over downtown Jamestown. Lots of sunshine, some rain moving across our area later on this afternoon. If you missed anything we talked about, news 24/7, WNYNewsNow.com. Download our mobile app. We'll see you tomorrow.
See you tomorrow.